I'm Norm Poltenson, the publisher of the Business Journal. I'd like to share with you a report card this morning on the efforts of our governor and the recently passed budget for the state of New York. I'm frankly delighted that the governor has made some huge inroads in what has been traditionally defined as our dysfunctional state. The budget came in at a whopping $132.5 billion, but keep in mind that's flat. That's about what we spent last year. And of that $132.5 billion, $87 billion comes from state taxes and the rest comes from feds. Now, the key here is to look at the growth drivers in the budget. And if we look at Medicaid, it grew by about 4%. That's the projection. And the same for school aid. Those are the two major items that we look at. So in a sense, compared to what they have grown at in the past, the governor's made substantial progress in holding down the cost of growth. He also took a budget gap of $25 billion over 2 years and has brought that down to $2 billion, which I think deserves kudos. And he did it without any gimmicks, to which we've been accustomed to in the last 30 years, including the gimmicks that his father was fond of. The property tax cap is still there at 2% and holding, and since we're not spending more money at the state level, it's having a substantial impact on those people who had to pay the property tax. And I give the governor very high marks for his continuing efforts to streamline state government and to make it more efficient and to do more consolidation. Now, that's one side of the report card. And what's the other side of the report card? The things that didn't get done. Medicaid is $54 billion out of a budget of $132.5 billion. And that's because we have a Cadillac plan, which offers everything that's available. And we also have more enrollees than anybody else. We're in a state with fewer than 20 million people. 5 million of them are now on the rolls of Medicaid. That's an 84% increase just since the year 2000. School aid is now at the point where we spend $18,126 per student on our secondary education. That is 73% above the national average. And I didn't mention to you on Medicaid that Medicaid per person is 2 to 3 times above what the national average is. I also have to fault the governor for not attacking our state debt. State debt now is over $6 billion a year in interest alone, and that's just the debt that's on the books. I didn't mention the debt that's off the books, which has been issued by agencies over the year. We have no plan to reduce that state debt. The governor also promised assiduously in his campaign that he would never raise taxes in this climate. And yet last December he decided, yes, we need a millionaire's tax. And of course, the governor talked about transparency. We have to change the system. And yet we now have a budget where we still have 3 men in a room who are deciding what the budget's going to be. So much for transparency. But my biggest concern with the governor is that he did not follow through on what was a very dramatic change in pension reform. The governor had asked for an increase on employee contributions. He also wanted to drop the retirement percentage of salary from 60% to 50%. He looked at how it was calculated in terms of the pension and eliminated overtime from those calculations. The governor also, most importantly, instituted a defined contribution system in this tier 6 level for new employees to the state of New York. Unfortunately, very little of that got done, and I'd have to confess that the governor simply rolled over for the unions. If you put the package together of the positives and negatives, it depends on what your yardstick is. And if your yardstick is our dysfunctional government, the governor gets kudos. He gets a very high mark for what he's accomplished. If you look at it from the standpoint of his budget message in January of this year, where he said New York State is open for business, I would have to take issue with the governor until he addresses the real drivers like Medicaid and school expenditures, until he deals with the state debt problem, until he decides that we don't need more taxation, until he really believes in transparency, and finally institutes a pension reform where we have a defined contribution system as they did in Rhode Island with an all-Democratic government, I don't think we're open for business. I'm Norm Poltenson. My report card for the governor this year is a B-. Thanks for listening.